everybody, Akira's here, welcome back. So in the last episode, we discovered there's a secret, building here, where we got some, okay, hold on, wait, we got different colors. Secret project area here. So we need to have negative going to that one and positive going to this one. Okay, so negative goes to this blue wire here, we're gonna be tracing these around. This blue wire goes up here, around here. There, so we want the negative there. That looks good from what I can tell, right? Negative pointed that way. And then we need the positive, which goes down here, goes up, over, down, up, strung around. This probably isn't within code, I'm just guessing. Over here, up in here. Okay, so we want to turn a wheel. There we go. Then unlock it. Oh, come on. You know it does. Positive, right? Up, over, down. What's this?
Carl rejoiced at the unexpected source of heat.
Oh, nice.
As much as his freezing hands.
Ah, alright. Well, that was nice. That was a good find. Alright, so that, wait a minute, wait, it goes up, down, okay, it does, it comes over here, bounces over, comes down here, round, there we go, so that's positive, right? Yes, okay, and this is a negative, down here, maybe I got the wrong one, maybe I lost track, goes, circles around a few times, goes out this way, down this way, over here. Yeah, negative. What am I doing wrong? That looks good to me. I don't know what the problem is. Unless there's some issues. Wait, does this need to be turned on or something over here? What's going on? I must be smarter than the wires. Must be smarter than the wires. Oh, this is ridiculous, people. Ridiculous. All right, let's trace each of these wires, make sure that they're not going somewhere important. Okay, so that green wire goes nowhere. Yeah, neither of those green wires go anywhere. I wonder if I need to reverse it. If this needs to be positive and that one needs to be negative to unlock it, maybe. I don't know. You know, like maybe the exact opposite. Maybe that's what it needs to be. Let's try that. Maybe. It's worth a shot. Nope. All right, I will figure this out eventually. Well, the only thing I can think now is that maybe if one's positive, the other one has to be negative. So let's try working backwards that way. All right, we're gonna start here with the blue one. Blue goes down here, up, over, down, over here, do, around here. There we go. So do we want that to be positive or negative? I'm thinking, since that said positive, we want this to be negative. Let's try that. Okay, and then red, because this one was, yeah, that was positive. So let's try doing it this way. All right. Red is gonna be positive. So we're gonna take the red and we're gonna make whatever red plugs into negative. There we go. Okay, so that's already set up right. Now we need to go yellow positive, and we're gonna follow that over, 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 down, around here, and that's positive. Was that right? Yellow is, oh no, we need to make that negative, right? I think we need to make this negative. Look here. Let's try that. Okay, now we got the green, which is positive. We're gonna take it over here, wrap it around. This is positive, positive. Green up, down, round, along the edge, all the way over here, all the way over here. And then green comes in here. So that was positive. So this needs to be negative, maybe? Okay. That sounded good. That sounded good.
Open.
It worked. All right. Finally. Some of a key.
So big an effort for an oh so tiny piece of metal.
I would have just taken the, I would have just taken the crowbar and tore off a couple slats here, but hey, whatever. Let's warm up here real quick. All right, so there we go, finally. My gosh, it took some time. All right. Where are we gonna, you guys wanna keep going south? I don't know. I guess we could. We can run down south. If we get cold, we can always run back here. See what's going on. Since we're already halfway down here. Maybe it won't let us. Maybe it'll stop us. Who knows? Oh, there's a bag here I didn't even look at. What we got here? Nothing? Eh, alright. Where are we at on the map anyway? We're probably going to come out at the back of that house down there. I don't know if we want to go too far, but I guess we could. We could take a little look at least. Or not. Yep. Game's going to stop us from going any further. Okay. Alright, well, let's head on back to the garage. I will say that was a pretty interesting puzzle. I imagine if I was an electrician or had any type of electrical training at all, that would have went a lot easier. Knowing to, you know, do positive to negative, that sort of thing. I should have thought about it the way you use batteries, but didn't really go through my head that way. For whatever reason. Alright, let's keep going. Already killed one wolf. Let's go ahead and get our axe out because we might need it again. That's pretty effective, I will say. As a wolf dispatching device, it worked well. I'm happy with it. I'm gonna give it a 5-star on Amazon. Something's already hauled away the wolf's body, it looks like. I have no idea how deep I am into the episode as far as time. I was messing around with that puzzle for so long. I've sort of completely lost track of time. So I'm just going to have to try to guess when it feels like I've actually done, because I'm going to have to, you know, obviously I had to time lapse me fumbling around for 20 minutes trying to figure out that puzzle. All right. Head back here. See if the key, see if we can just put the key in there maybe. I don't know. See, I thought we'd have to put a headlight on there. Don't we? No skis down there. Please check. So we can't do anything with the key. We're just going to need that eventually. We need handlebars, skis, track. All right. Well, I got that. Let's go ahead and get out of here. And maybe we'll go down to Jilly's house or whatever his name is.
Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the...
Let me throw some wood in there if I have it. Yeah, let's throw that in there. Fill gas can, yeah, let's throw that in there. What else don't we really need to be carrying around? Yeah, I'll keep the rest. Everything else looks pretty sensible.
Wealth contained in Lamotte's lands.
What? All right. It looks like it's stacking wood in there. That's kind of cool. So, I think where we'll go from here is kind of head back towards the general store. And, yeah. So we're just going to head on back. And I think his was the first building south of the general store. So let's head back there. Check that. Keep on going. Yeah, it seemed like this winter coat actually really helped out quite a bit. You know, hold on. Sorry. It's a tough truck. She'll do fine. No worries there. I'll actually drive this up here a little bit. See if maybe there's an outbuilding or something up here. Oh, it won't let me. Yeah, it won't let me. Which seems kind of accurate. I mean, you wouldn't want to drive your truck through that snow like that. Get stuck pretty quick. Okay, well, maybe once we get the snowmobile, we'll check out these areas. Now we have two fuel sources for the snowmobile. Got this garage down south, and we have the regular gas station. That load time there, that transition load time is insanely long. I mean, I'm so not used to that. Used to be like games like 15 years ago used to do that. Modern games, not so much. All right. So, I thought I saw on the map there was something about a cave down this way too. But, let's head over here. I think his house is... I haven't passed it yet. So, yeah, there's a cave there. All right. I don't know why that's on the map. I don't think I discovered that. Maybe I read about it somewhere and I'm just forgetting it. Okay, here's his mailbox. Let's go and check his mailbox, of course. Seems like they tend to have goodies inside of them. A letter, of course. It won't let me take it? Okay, there we go. Thank you for the translation. To Mr. Gil LaChance. Dear Mr. LaChance, we have carefully taken note of your complaint regarding the collapse of natural cave on your property. Oh, okay. However, given the absence of any actual damage or injury, we cannot move forward with this investigation. The natural cave cannot be considered personal belonging. Furthermore, your claim regarding the landslides caused by the work in the new DW Inc. mine seem outlandish, as the mine is miles away from your property. Also, it is imperative that you secure your property, as you would be held accountable for any injuries caused by the steep terrain. This is where crying wolf leads you. Sincerely, Pierre Valjean. Alright. Wonderful. So let's be careful around the cave. I guess it's... little warning there. What's going on here? Why is there a flaming arrow? Is that what that is? A flaming arrow? Okay. Someone's shooting flaming arrows. That indicates it's probably pretty recent, and it indicates that I probably want to get my pistol out. Very, very, very interesting. Take out camera. Okay.
Bolt stuck into the wooden stair.
Crossbow.
Reminded Carl of the arrow that was said to have hit Achilles' heel. But who was the intended Achilles this time?
Looks like there's some. All right, we'll keep that. But I want to take another picture. Looks like there's some more, blood or something, I can't tell. Let's take a look. No. Huh, it's weird. Okay. I can throw that away. Let's get that pistol back out. Let's grab a log in case we need to get the stove going in here. 1555. Alright, let's just do a sweep of the perimeter here. It's a loud radio. That might be the mine, maybe? Yeah, that'll be the cave. Alright, we can head on down there real quick, take a look around. Not much I can do here. Maybe take a picture? I don't know. Thinking maybe I will. I'll take it. It seems like it's a pointless picture if it gives you the option to throw it away. Seems like that might be important, but as of right now, it isn't. Oh my gosh. Oh, is the cold getting to me? Is that what that means? Maybe I was just freaking out when I was looking at him. I don't know. Looks like the tracks went this way. Yeah, see how it didn't give me an option to throw that away that time? Alright. Not sure why my guy was freaking out so much looking at the frozen body. I should be getting used to it by now. Alright, let's see if we can get inside here. Oh yeah, no worries. In the bucket? No. Trash can? Nope.
Was freezing right down oh, wow. to the bone.
Can we get this going? Let's get this fire going here. There we go. Alright, well, let's see what happened to him here.
Worldly ice had struck again. The woman's hopes and dreams were frozen in eternity.
Oh, this is a woman. This isn't... I guess that's right.
Cool, tingling sensation in his body.
He was, took over him. He was at, LaChance was actually in the truck accident, wasn't he? Forgot about that. Oh, what we got here?
Something was hidden under the stairs.
Alright, gotcha. Where do we go? Torches are glowing. Turn that off, that annoys me. There we go.
The man grabbed his rifle. Carl felt a sense of dread in him.
That must have been the guy who's running with a rifle in the first hallucination that we had, or whatever it is. First vision, I'll say. Not really hallucination. Bertrand LaChance, 1948. Okay. What's next? Footsteps? Whoa. What am I?
Perhaps
what is this?
Their
oh.
spousal relationship had been cooling down lately.
Okay.
It seemed like secrecy was commonplace in this house.
Man, you ain't kidding. All kinds of little. Yeah. Kind of a little trap. It's like a little trap house. Alright. Oh wow, I got her whole diary? Lifted,
and he was back to reality.
Okay.
A reality in which Giselle, Jill's loving spouse, was motionless, frozen in ice.
Alrighty. Well, we'll read this real quick, and then we'll go ahead and call it an end of the episode here. So let's do this. Giselle, September. Mother once told me when I first met Jill, that I hadn't picked the brightest bulb in the lot. And as always, as the years fly by, I'm seeing the truth of her words. Always trust your mother's wisdom. That blackmailing scheme is a prime example of Jill's brightness. He's like a small dog. He thinks he's bigger than he actually is. He growls, genuinely thinking he's scary, but everyone knows he can be pushed aside with a little kick. He truly believes he can blackmail Hamilton, the big boss himself. It's going to be a long time in hell before my poor Jill has managed to pull off such a feat. After all, Hamilton's a rich, learned, influential man. Not only is he blackmailing idea bad to begin with, let's be honest, Jill is way out of his league, but Jill doesn't even know how he's actually going to carry it out. I don't think he ever would. He's just throwing random threats out loud in the kitchen. He says he'll do it eventually, but I know better. Successful blackmailing requires masterful cunning, and Jill is a master of nothing. Wow. He's a slave and forever will be. Oh, man. Harsh. I often look at that safe he keeps hidden in the fake wall in which he stores all these incriminating documents he intends to use, and I just can't come to grips with the sheer ridiculousness of the whole thing. Alright. Okay, well, we will check out the house here when we come back in the next episode. So like, comment, subscribe. I hope you guys are enjoying the series still. I know I am. And I'll see you in the next episode.